We will see one more simplified block diagram of the data acquisition system. So in this block diagram we can able to see the physical system from where we are going to sense the physical parameter of any kind. So physical variable, for example temperature, pressure, motion related information or any flow based information. Then the transducer is responsible to produce or to sense these particular parameters. So from this particular transducer we are getting the noisy electrical signal, and this particular noisy electrical signal or the weak signals that we are getting from this sensor are then passed to the signal conditioning block or signal conditioning circuitry. So this signal conditioning circuitry is responsible to filter the distorted signals. So in this picture we can able to see here this is nothing but the noisy analog signal, and from this particular signal conditioning we are getting filtered cleared analog signal or amplified or boosted electrical signal. Now these electrical signals are given to the A to D converter, analog to digital converter, who is responsible to convert the analog information to digital depending on the computer, either is working on 8-bit, 16-bit or 12-bit or 32-bit or 64-bit of data. AD converter will provide the sampled output or digital data to the computer. Then depending on the values obtained from the AD converter and the binary information or hexadecimal number or binary code, the computer will take the appropriate decision or to provide a command to the actuator that we discussed in earlier slide. So this is about the simplified one more block diagram of the data acquisition system. Now we are going to discuss the classification of the sensor. So in this particular hierarchical diagram we can able to see the classification of the sensors based on the different scenarios or applications. So sensors are mainly classified based on the first one, so based on the measured value. So either you are measuring the temperature of any system, either you are measuring the pressure of the wall, or if you are measuring the pressure or force or torque speed, position of the particular object, light kind of information. So depending on the measured value, different sensors are available. Next classification section, that is based on the power source. So as we as I said a few minutes before, the sensors are classified in two main categories, that is active and passive kind of sensors. So the sensor who require the external source or energy for working of the sensor, so active sensors are nothing but the sensors who require the external source. For example, the RTD is nothing but resistor temperature dependent thermistor. So these are the temperature sensors. And the passive sensors, that is thermocouple or thermopile or photodiode kind of sensors. Next classification, the sensor that is based on the output signal. Again, as I said a few minutes before, either you are getting the output from the particular sensor in the form of analog signal or digital signal. So if you are considering the analog sensor, for example the thermocouple, RTD, strain gauge kind of sensor, so these are the sensors who are responsible to produce the analog signals. And the digital sensors or the modules who can responsible to produce the output in the form of digital, that is binary kind of output. For example, this is your DST11 kind of sensor, that is temperature and moisture sensor, that means that particular module can give you the output directly in the form of digital format. Then the application based classification nothing but the depending on the area used or depending on the area or the application. For example, the agricultural field, the crop related or any soil or moisture kind of related some sensors. So agricultural field point of view, then automotive kind of applications, then civil and infrastructure or construction line related applications. For example, structural analysis or structural monitoring kind of applications. For example, stress strain, then your load cell. So these kind of sensor, domestic appliances, home appliances, commerce, finance, environment, meteorological application, security purpose, home security applications. For example, occupancy detection, vision sensor, renewable energy related some sensors are available, that is photo cell, photoelectric cell, telecommunication related some sensors are available, that is radio wave and wireless related some sensors are available, healthcare and medical application oriented sensors are again classified, marine, military and space related again sensors are available. So depending on the application or the requirement, the modifications in the sensor, either in the form of the material used or any kind of what we can say, the dimensions, the specifications, the components, the specification or the material use, either the capacitive, resistive or semiconductor material. So depending on the applications, all these parameters get changed. Then specification based, as I said, depending on the requirement or the sensor which is observed in the particular application. For example, your agricultural application or any automotive application, the type of the sensor or the requirements from the sensor may get changed. So specification point of view, here you have to consider the accuracy of the particular sensor, how accurate is your sensor. Then sensitivity, how sensitive is the sensor who can give the output to your system. Stability, for example, stability parameter of the sensor, for example temperature sensor, maximum stability of the sensor with respect to the maximum temperature. Response time of the sensor, so response time is nothing but the one of the parameter of a specification of the sensor is that how responsive is your sensor, that is after the sensing of the particular parameter, how much the time required to process it and to produce the output. So the sensor should give the output in real time. So responsive nature of the sensor. Hysteresis, so hysteresis is nothing but if suppose you are getting the number of outputs for a single input for the sense parameter, and the difference between the two outputs can be checked with the help of hysteresis, and we can analyze the variations in the output. Frequency response of the particular sensor. Then what kind of input we are giving to the particular sensor, that also matters. Then resolution of the sensor. So resolution nothing but the smallest change in the output with respect to the particular input or variation in the input. The next specification, that is linearity. So linearity is nothing but the sensor should provide the linear in output, which is nothing but with respect to the change in the input, the sensor should give the output. So linearity of the particular sensor is the important parameter. Then hardness is there, then manufacturing cost, size and weight, these are the other parameters also need to consider in this particular classification. Then physical law based classification, which is nothing but the different physical principles based on the physical principle, that is photoelectric principle based sensor, then magnetoelectric based sensor, thermoelectric photoconductive kind of sensor, photomagnetic kind of working principle, then thermomagnetic, thermo-optic, thermochemical based classification, then magneto-resistive, photo-elastic. So these are the depending on the physical principles of the sensors. Then next classification, proprioceptive and exteroceptive kind of classification. So proprioceptive means the sensors like motor speed, that is angular velocity measurement, then wheel load analysis, then robot and its angle movement, the angle, then battery voltage. So these are the based on this particular first type. And the second one, that is exteroceptive, where we are measuring the distance, light intensity and the sound amplitude kind of sensors. Then depending on the type of the material used in the particular sensor, as I said, again classification of the sensor based on the sensor material. So organic and inorganic kind of sensors, either the sensor is designed or the manufactured by using organic, inorganic, again depending on the principle, that is resistive, then capacitive or semiconductor based sensors. Then depending on the type of the physical parameter or stimuli, for example the acoustic wave measurement kind of classification, electric parameter measurement, electrical value measurement, then magnetic field and detection, optical detection, then mechanical displacement, angular velocity, linear displacement kind of measurement, then radiation based stimuli or any kind of parameter, then thermal sensor. So vision and thermal sensor, these are again categorized in this particular stimuli. So depending on the physical environment or physical parameters, again classification of the sensors. So as far as your syllabus is concerned, the classification are given in the tabular form. So I think no need to repeat again, which is which are the classifications are given in this particular in these tables. So sensitivity and stimulus range or span. So stability of the particular sensor, that is short and long term point of view. How the stable is your sensor, the accuracy of your sensor, how accurately your sensor is responsible to give the output, speed of response or response time, that we already discussed, that is time required to produce the output. Then overload characteristics. So overload characteristics is nothing but your sensors should withstand at the loaded condition also. Then hysteresis, operating life or lifespan of the particular sensor, the cost of the sensor, manufacturing cost and the consumer or the customer oriented cost of the particular sensor, dimensions of the sensor, that is height, width and all dimensions are need to consider. So depending on the application, as I said, the dimensions and the categories of the sensors are available, weight of the sensor, then stimulus range, resolution, already we discussed, sensitivity, selectivity is one more parameter. Depending on the particular application or domain, the selection of the particular sensor, environmental condition is nothing but, for example, suppose industrial application, foundry industry. So in the foundry industry, it is observed that high temperature. So depending on the foundry and the temperature of the environment, the selection of the sensor is most important. Then the linearity property of the particular sensor, dead band, output format and other parameters. So as I said a few minutes before, the depending on the material used in the sensor, again classification is there, that is inorganic and organic. So inorganic, where you will find the conductor kind of material, semiconductor and biological substance based sensor, and in organic kind of sensor or organic material based sensor, you will find the insulator, the liquid gas or plasma based some sensor and other advanced materials in the sensor. Then depending on the detection of or detection parameter, so detection means used in the sensor, either that particular sensor used in the biological application or in the chemical industry or chemical reactor or any kind of application, the electric, magnetic and electromagnetic wave detection kind of application, then heat and temperature oriented, mechanical displacement or wave related application, the angular displacement or linear displacement kind of operations. Then radioactivity and radiation based sensors also available or categorized in this particular detection based classification. Then depending on the conversion phenomena, again some classifications are done. So depending on the conversion, the physical depending on the physical phenomena, that is thermoelectric effect, photoelectric effect, then photomagnetic effect, then magnetoelectric, magnetoelectric kind of conversion, then thermoelastic, electrostatic, thermocouple. So here depending on the type of the material used and the conversion factor, classification is done. Then depending on the chemical reaction or chemical conversion point of view, so here chemical transformation, physical transformation, electrochemical process and spectroscopy kind of application based sensor and the classification. Biological application oriented, where the biochemical transformation and the physical transformation, where the effect on the test organism spectroscopy is observed. So as we discussed a few minutes before, depending on the application, the different sensors are classified. So in this table we can able to see agricultural and automotive kind of some applications and other applications. So civil engineering, construction oriented, then distribution, commerce, finance, renewable energy, power, health, medicine, medicine manufacturing, depending on the chemical industries, health line, then scientific measurement related some sensor, then transportation or automotive kind of sensors, domestic or appliances, home appliances, again depending on the home appliances the different sensors are observed, then environmental effect oriented or meteorological based some sensor, information transmission reception, wireless signal and telecommunication, marine application, toys. So in this way, depending on the application, classification is observed. So this is about the stimulus or the physical parameter from the particular object. So stimulus parameters, so here we can, in this table we can able to see the acoustic wave kind of stimulus parameter, where the wave amplitude, phase or polarization, spectrum, wave velocity can be sensed. Then biological stimulus, where the biomass types and concentration and states can be detected by the sensor. Then chemical environment or chemical stimulus parameter, where the component identities, concentrations, states and other parameters. Then the electrical parameter or electrical stimulus, where we are going to, or the sensors are classified according to the charge detection, current variation, potential voltage variation, electric field, where the amplitude, phase and polarization, spectrum based sensor. Again, conductivity parameter or conductivity based, permittivity based sensors, magnetic field detection or magnetic effect based some sensors are there, where the amplitude phase polarization detection, magnetic flux detection, and according to that the output. Then permeability, one more parameter need to consider in this particular magnetic field. Then the next optical stimulus, where the wave amplitude phase polarization again can be sensed, where the wave velocity can be detected by the sensor, refractive index detection, variations in the index value, and according to that produce the electrical output. Emissivity, reflectivity, absorption based concepts are considered in this particular type of sensors. Then again, depending on the mechanical parameters or physical parameters available in the mechanical field, where the position can be detected, or position detection either in angular or linear form, acceleration detection or acceleration sensor, force sensor, stress pressure sensor, strain gauge, strain sensor, mass detection, density detection, moment sensor, torque of the particular rotating object, torque detection, speed of the flow. Then rate of mass transport, shape, roughness, orientation of the object, stiffness of the object, compliance, viscosity of the particular material, viscosity of the liquid, then crystallinity, structural integrity, and other mechanical parameter based some classifications of the sensor. Then the radiation based sensor, where the type of the sensor, where energy, intensity, and other parameter can be sensed by the sensor. Then thermal based, where it is observed that the temperature detector, temperature detection based sensor, flux detection sensor, specific heat detectors, then thermal conductivity based some sensors. So in this way, depending on the type of the application, the environment, and the material used or need of the particular user, different sensors are available in the market. So we will stop here. In the next lecture